It's Marina here from Yes to Tech. Welcome to Tech Tuesday, where we remove the tech stress that comes along with running a successful online business. Today we're going to talk about how to record your face and screen at the same time in Mac. This comes in handy when you're doing a webinar or want to record something for an online course and want to provide your audience with information while at the same time connecting with them on a personal level so that you can make more sales and help them get better results. Stay tuned until the end of this video to learn how to record your face and screen at the same time in Mac and to get my webinar sales funnel template that'll help you boost your webinar signup rate, increase the number of people who show up live, and skyrocket your sales. Also, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every Tuesday when I post a new video. All right, so let's get right into how to record your face and screen at the same time in Mac. The way we're going to do this is with QuickTime, a multimedia software that comes for free in all Mac computers. That allows you to record your face, screen, audio, or all three at the same time. To open QuickTime, you can either go to Finder, Applications, and then select QuickTime, or use the search tool in the menu up top to open the Spotlight search. Start typing in QuickTime and click on the app to open it. When you open QuickTime and click on File from the menu up top, you'll be prompted with three options: New Movie Recording, New Audio Recording, and New Screen Recording. My New Screen Recording section is grayed out because I'm currently using QuickTime to do this exact screen recording. The first thing you'll want to do is click on New Movie Recording. Hello there. So this recorder is connected to your computer's camera or to your webcam if you have one, and that is what will provide you with the recording of your face. This button in the middle with the red circle is a record button. And if you click on the downward pointing arrow next to it, you can edit which camera and microphone you'll be using for your recording, as well as whether it'll be in high quality or maximum quality. Since we'll be recording our entire screen and not just this specific movie recording, there is no need to change these settings over here or press this record button. When doing our screen recording, we'll be using the microphone settings from there, and the camera from this movie recording will save our face and our movements. Since we'll be doing two recordings at the same time, decrease the size of the movie recording screen to its smallest size, which is this one over here, and reposition its window so that it's in one of the corners of the screen. So either here, 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 here. Let's leave it up top. Now what you'll want to do is click on View from the menu up top and select Float on Top. What this does is fix your movie recording screen above all other windows so that if you open up another window or application, it'll still be visible, ensuring that your face is always apparent to your viewers. Now, there's just one limitation with this. It doesn't work with a full screen mode from your browser, as you can see, but you can manually resize your browser so that it fills the screen. To start a new screen recording, click on File from the menu up top, and then on New Screen Recording. Now, this option is currently not visible to me since I'm currently using QuickTime to do this actual face and screen recording. But when you click on New Screen Recording, a similar recorder to the one we see with the movie recording will appear on your screen. If you click on the downward pointing arrow next to it, you can edit which microphone you'll be using for your recording and toggle whether you want to show mouse clicks in your recording or not. When you click on the red circle record button, a message will appear on your screen saying that you can just click on the screen to record the full screen or drag a selection with your mouse to choose the exact area you wish to record on your screen. If you choose the second option, just make sure that your movie recording is within that selection for it to be recorded as well. You'll know your screen recording has started when you can see a black stop button in the menu on the top right. QuickTime will now record absolutely everything that is on your screen, including the movie recording of your face in the corner. If you open up a new tab, new browser, or even a new application, QuickTime will record that as well. Once you're done and wish to end the recording, all you have to do is click on the stop button in the menu bar up top or click on Command, Control, Escape on your keyboard. Or if you have a touch bar, you can click on stop there as well. A playback window will automatically pop up. You can play it right then and there to see what it looks like, or directly click on File from the menu up top, and then on Save to save your face and screen recording. Now you know how to record your face and screen at the same time in Mac. If you plan on using this recording for your webinar and wish to take your webinar efforts to the next level so that you boost your webinar signup rate, increase the number of people who show up live, and skyrocket your sales, make sure to get my webinar sales funnel template by clicking on the link in the description box below. So, what do you plan on using your face and screen recording for? Leave your answer in the comments section below, and make sure to click on the link in the description box below to get my webinar sales funnel template. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.